Oi, 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 what is up, everybody? My name is Dylan. Welcome to youtube.com/DylanKG. And today we are discussing the 4.3.0 mid-chapter update. Now, real quick, if you are new to the channel, if you've never hit that subscribe button, consider subbing to the channel so that anytime news comes out for Dead by Daylight, you are kept up to date, as well as being given access and constant update reminders for our tutorials and our gameplay videos. But without further ado, let's dive in and take a look today. The biggest features of this update are obviously graphic updates and perk changes. The Executioner is getting a huge balance update. Now, what the dev said is that the cost of missing a punishment of the damned attack is too high. So they took and they made it, instead of a 2.75 second cooldown after using your ability, it is a 2.25 second cooldown. So they took half a second off there. But if you're using your Rites of Judgment, if you're dragging your blade in the ground, you actually have a longer wait time after pulling your blade out of the ground before you can M1 basic attack somebody. It's a full second before you could do that. It used to be a half second, so they added a half second there. So a little bit of a change to how oppressive Pyramid Head could be. If somebody fakes a window vault and you want to pull your rites out of the ground and try to hit them, you do have to wait a second, which could change him a little bit. I don't think this is going to be a drastic change, and I don't think that this change is going to impact the way Pyramid Head plays for the most part at all. I think actually we might see more of the Punishment of the Damned random spamming at pallets and things like that. We'll see what happens. Of course, the perks were also changed. The Trail of Torment, if you kick a gen, you're now undetectable until the gen is done regressing or stops regression, so if somebody touches it, etc. Or a survivor is put into the dying state or injured. Forced Penance has an increased amount of time where people are broken, and Blood Pact gives a 5, 6, or 7% haste status effect until the survivors are no longer within 16 meters of each other. So, hey, Aaron, Useless, Tithy, I want you guys to get together. With your power combined, you can make a Hope Blood Pact adrenaline video. I know you can do it. I know you can do it. All right. The other perk updates are not that big a deal. We're going to talk about the biggest ones here, is that Thanatophobia no longer affects healing speed for killers, and the penalties have been increased. So it's 4%, 4.5%, and 5% to gen, gen speed, sabo speeds, things like that. It does not affect healing speed anymore. So those of you running Thanatophobia on Legion are still in a good spot. If you're running Thana on anything else, not in a great spot. If you guys are using Mindbreaker, the effect now lasts 3, 4, and 5 seconds, and I have a feeling that with Tinkerer being a part of everybody's build lately, Mindbreaker will also be part of the build, because this means that now people are exhausted for 5 seconds after they leave a generator. I think this is going to be very interesting. I don't know. I would like to see this in, like, Ghostface builds. I think we're going to see a lot of Mindbreaker in Ghostface builds. That's what I'm saying. That's where I'm going. Discordance has a limited range. This is a new thing that I don't think actually discussed in the PTB. Discordance has a limited range of 32, 64, or 96 meters. It triggers one loud noise for a generator when it's first marked. The aura of the generator remains visible as long as the conditions are fulfilled. From the time the conditions are no longer fulfilled, the aura remains for another 8 seconds. So just like a little bit more specification, and it has a limited range for Suffocation Pit, Azeroth, those larger maps that are bigger than 96 meters. I don't know if those are actually bigger than 96. I would assume they are. Pop Goes the Weasel also now lasts 35, 40, or 45 seconds, a 15 second nerf from the 60 seconds that we had previously. Not a big deal. If you're complaining over Pop Goes the Weasel getting nerfed, I get good. I don't know. You figure it out. And of course, Technician, if you're a new player, Technician prevents all generator explosions from missed skill checks, but the generator loses additional progress, of course. So generator terminology was updated. You could check that out on the accompanying perks. Go take a look at that, or look at it on the update page here. The visual updates, of course, McMillan was updated. Visual update to lockers. Not really sure what that is, because they were already updated. They added footsteps graphic effects, so you can now see footsteps in the mud and footprints and things like that. A little bit interesting. I hope they continue to iterate on that, because I think that'd be really fun. Visual update to all blood, so there's a little blood squirt, little blood pool. updated the visual effects for Tripper, Wraith, and Hillbilly. Still haven't seen those actually yet. I don't know what that actually looks like. Even during the PTB, I don't know what that looked like. And they updated the Dissolve visual effects in-game and in lobbies, so things look a little whooshier, a little shinier. 4K UI icons now have better resolution at 4K. Perks have been changed as well. So you notice you used to have yellow perks, green perks, and purple perks. And some of the green perks at tier 3 were still green, and some of the purple perks were purple at tier. It was a mess. It's weird. Now, if something is tiered up and it's rank 3, it'll be purple. If it's rank 2, it'll be green. I believe that is what that means. Correct me if I'm wrong. Comment down below. Bug fixes. You guys can check that here. There was not anything too crazy. They said they fixed an issue that caused players to have less control on their character after being unhooked. That bug has been in the game for about 2 full chapters now. So you get unhooked and your turn radius would be like way thicker. It was like you were on controller suddenly on PC. So that's been changed. And fixed an issue that might cause players to receive the torment effect at random times when playing against the executioner. I haven't seen that, but you know, that's interesting. I like that. And here's a known issue. Nobody's gonna. Hey, if you made it this far in the video, comment down below. The killer will sometimes see an incorrect animation during the start of the match, during the camera pan. Not a big deal. What do you guys think of the updates? Let me know down below what perks got the worst nerf. Do you think the Pyramid Head update matters at all? Guys, please go out, get some water, get some sunshine today before you hunker down and you play some DBD. Unclench your jaw, and I will pray to the entity to see you in the next videos.